started speaking for Arsenal.
Come on!
Yeah. Chance to go 4 points clear of Manchester City and Spurs, just 6 games into the season by maintaining their 100% start. And what a recovery it's been for Manchester United, having lost their first 2, 3 wins on the bounce, have them within touching distance of the top six as well. How do you see it this afternoon, Roy?
I fancy them strongly. I really do. I think it's a brilliant start. United recover well, all the set
of teams. Those ones opposite you?
Obviously, built on the momentum they got from the Liverpool game.
What is
good results, obviously, Southampton and Leicester at home to the big game Arsenal. So I'm going to see United losing.
But have you been convinced by those away performances?
I just think it's been efficient in a couple of clean sheets. This is a settled team. I think they'll sacrifice today. I don't think this team, United team at the moment, would be obsessed with possession. I think Arsenal get plenty of joy from that point of view.
No, that's something more to
a relief now. Fernandes has done really well. His leadership. Again, settled back four. Plenty of pace.
That makes sense.
And I think there's good signs for United.
But there is new confidence about this Arsenal team, Paul. Will they go into this with a bit of swagger? Oh. Should they?
100%. What a time to come here. Oh, okay. Five on the trot, scoring goals, playing well. But I think he's the most important captain I've got. I think him playing today. When you've got some trouble, they'll get a lot of the ball. You've got to be so difficult. You've got people who aren't passing. He can find a pass. He's got pace on his side. He's got movement up front. With the amount of talent on show and a lot of players are playing in Robbie at the moment, I can't see how they're going to be goals in this game. I really can't.
What, are you confident about Arsenal's chances?
I am. I'm a lot more than what I was. I think, you know, when I look back now, I'm looking at the horse. I said, I'm going to down get beat at Wolves 1-0. You know, Man United down beat Leicester last week 1-0 Thursday night. I just watched Leicester get beat 5. Do you know what I mean? If you're looking at form-wise, I don't see why Arsenal can't get anything
I think we will know an awful lot more about both these teams and their prospects this season at about 6:30 this evening. Our match commentators, Gary Neville and Martin Tyler.
Thanks, Davis. Afternoon, everyone. Manchester United looking for a 4th straight win since their 4-0 drubbing at Brentford. But Arsenal out to extend their 100% start to the season and their lead at the top of the Premier League. So after identical 11 to the last 3 games and 3 wins, Erik ten Hag has made just one change. We'll come to that in a moment. Javi De Gea with back-to-back clean sheets at Southampton and Leicester, and it's the same back four that helped him earn a shutout. In midfield, the former Scotland Tony keeps Casemiro still waiting for his first start for United. James Sancho got the winner on Thursday. Bruno Fernandes the same at St Mary's last weekend. And now joined by new signing Anthony. United made Ajax an offer they just couldn't refuse. Matching his own Marcus Rashford up top. With another new name on the bench, goalkeeper Martin Dubravka, who comes from Newcastle United, of course. Mikel Arteta trusting in the youth of his team. And an extra recovery day too for midweek. Nottingham Aaron probably benefited from that. He has made it despite rumours to the contrary. And a return to Manchester for the former City left back, Oleg Sinchenko, who's missed the last couple of games with a knee injury. The late but failed midfield Villa's Douglas Luiz indicated the need for midfield reinforcement. But Martin Odegaard is here. He came off before the end on Wednesday. Thomas Partey will be back very soon. Gabriel Jesus knows all about matches against Manchester United, but he didn't score in any of them in any 11 derbies with City. On the bench, Kieran Tierney is back there after a couple of starts in the absence of Sinchenko. Arsenal have passed all their tests so far, but now it's United, and it's live!
Well, it's so exciting to be able to see how empty it is today. 75,000 in this ground, looking forward to it. And we don't normally say for any signing that they need a better period, but I think it's so important that Anthony starts well in his Manchester United career over his last 10 years. The ones who haven't started well are really sure to reverse that trend. So, see how he does today up against Zinchenko and Arsenal. And for me, I think the real key battles in this game today, you don't say midfield, but I think the wide areas. Saka against Malicia, Dallo against Martinelli, Zinchenko and Anthony, Ben White is the very different one of those fullbacks in the sense that he's a centre back who goes out there, and him against Sancho could be pivotal.
Mikel Arteta is still the youngest Premier League manager at 40. His first was against United in January 2020.
All right, well, I'll have a look at that one.
And some Dutch courage has given Manchester United a real lift. They are both truly in form and about to be in action from the first whistle from referee Paul Tierney. Here we go, it's been a warm afternoon. It's actually got warmer and warmer as the clock has ticked off. Bit of cloud at kick-off, which is nice, I appreciate. Plenty of warmth in the atmosphere as well. I think it's fueled, Gary, by the performance, but not just the result against Liverpool.
Yeah, it's absolutely stark difference from the ones in the weeks before. And there's a bit of a buzz before this game, well, from both sides.
Jadon Sancho scored a couple of calmly taken goals. It doesn't matter if they're there for the full course. United on their way. And the winner at the King Power on the grid. Here is Anthony. Talking over £90 million if all the add-ons come through.
It is. And Ajax just didn't want to let him go this summer, but that strategy changed when they saw the scale a bit.
And a weaving run. He's still going. Got a good hit by Saliba. And by Malacia. Now got there. Here he is again. And right back. Rashford for the cutback. Behind him. And it's quite right reach. Fernandes. And Gabriel Jesus leads the charge in the other half of the pitch.
Martinez. Oh! Well, we actually got a decision.
He let his man get free and just commit the foul. Suddenly, from looking at potential scorer at one end, they've got the defender at the other, Manchester United.
Yeah, a couple of dirty moments, Arsenal, but it gets cleared. And one shot he fouls against someone like Gabriel Jesus, you're in a little bit of trouble, and he just physically out-muscled
Lisandro
Martinez. And he just hacked him in the end. He'd be looking to get away without a bucket. This is where Dallo goes through the Arsenal defence. And it's this clearance that puts Jesus away.
Have plenty of opportunities in successful Manchester City teams as well in the derbies.
Yeah.
And they've got encouragement from that first encounter with Manchester United centre backs.
But that was a poor free kick just then.
Teams so early in the season, they should be okay.
With all the talk of rotation, that not too much of it's been going on, really. Here's the five subs help. You can take some of your players off and still remain your first choice players, even if they've had the coaches like to say too many minutes on the pitch.
to colleagues in the Olympic gold winning team for Brazil. As he played in the final, Martinelli didn't. Gold medals. Martinez. Now Burak. Now Harry Maguire. Of course, no Cristiano Ronaldo. Hasn't had a proper pre-season. He's paying the price for it to some extent. Change with Russia. Back and get it back again. No one really pressing it from Arsenal's point of view. And here's the new boy. It's cross. Deep enough. That's little for Sancho. It's straight across to this side. Anthony goes on. And Gabriel Jesus has never been shy of dropping back to help out. He's got into trouble.
Yeah, it's not foul, he just stopped it, referee had to, because Jesus got a bang on the head, as you say, Martin. And it is a bit of a clattering, I think. I think his head bounces against the ground. I think it's the right thing for the referee to do that. The whole crowd aren't happy. But I think if you see a replay of that, then you'll know why Paul Tierney is right to stop the game.
Bruno Fernandes in the capacity of Manchester United's captain having a say. Here it is.
Yeah, it was a fair challenge. McTominay does well, but it's that there.
Well, Gabriel Jesus has brought a purpose to Arsenal, but Arsenal have brought a purpose to him as well. They said, you're going to play up front. You're going to be our main striker. And so far, it's brilliantly for both parties. Intriguing to see the two former Manchester City players involved here in Manchester. The ball is going to be dropped for Anthony, and on we go. Martinez. Alright, Dallo. And we're not right back now, first choice. Anthony. And he's been playing in first time, and Christian Eriksen! Well, it's not beyond his skill to put that in the back of the net.
Well, it's good all round. Anthony looks like he gets himself into a cul-de-sac in a bit of trouble, but he somehow, a little cheeky Cruyff pass out of it. It's a wonderful delivery from Dallo, and it comes right round the back, Eriksen. Just can't wrap that left boot around it. Comes off his shin, I think, in the end. And we thought it would be a quick start, and it has been. Silly from McTominay.
There we go. Catch United out. Comes across. Oh, Foster. Well, he's got one already this season. It's a harder chance to take than the one he's just missed here.
Sharp stuff from Arsenal. He just opens up his body too much. Probably one of the players that Mikel Arteta wouldn't have wanted that chance to fall to. What a big moment.
Here's Anthony. And plenty of early involvement. Rashford. Here's a misjudgment by Bukayo Saka. Clear it. Ericsson into Rashford. He's wanting it back, getting it back. Right back from Sancho, that's been close to offside. Right. A hole by Manchester United up. Navarra. McTominay. Pace in the passing of Manchester United. Bruno Fernandes. Sancho against White. Has a go carried out by Ramsdale. Sancho McTominay. He's landed a few goals from that kind of area for United. Sancho again. Matthew's coming ahead of Ericsson. Bruno Fernandes through the middle. Rashford going to win the try and go on the far side.
And they might have something here on the ball. And so just have to sit in and defend at the moment. Stay compact and tight.
Arsenal haven't conceded in their two away games so far. It's the Palace and Bournemouth. And of course, back here. No doubt made the challenge and they weren't complaining about it. Manchester United, suddenly Martinelli is in. Martinelli scores.
It could be rolled out, not sure. Could be rolled out.
And he's been doing plenty of saluting.
Yeah, but I don't know. He might have been offside.
No, fair.
Martinelli has his say. Bruno Fernandes saying there was a foul in the build-up.
Well, there are complaints, but I thought Ericsson was fairly dispossessed.
Ooh, even Gary Neville thinks
I don't think you could see the Manchester United player that came and got it off him. Here it is.
Even it's Gary Neville thinks it's right. Ooh.
He just steals it. There's a little nudge, but it's something and nothing. But from that moment, I have to say, look at the reaction on this near side. Look at Martinelli versus Dello. It's absolutely devastating for Martinelli. He cuts across Dello, who can't get back.
It's still being checked.
Oh, it might be a foul on that one. That's the one that maybe that knee could just go across.
VAR has been really in the headlines. The last 24 hours.
And the finish from Martinelli is absolutely brilliant. Oh, he's been asked to look at it. This is going to be
disallowed.
To be fair, we saw last. I think that knee, I think it is just a foul. From the other angle, it looked really soft. But there is that other angle that came out a little bit later, which I think means that it will be disallowed.
Some of these angles that you're seeing.
It's that knee there into the side of the thigh of Ericsson, which is going to cost Arsenal.
Here we go, reaching for the ball. Does he actually play it?
Oh! No, he doesn't play the ball.
But the referees do want. And have this physicality bar high.
Well, he's had a good thinking on it, Paul Tierney. I think he might do something maybe slightly different than we've seen before. He's had a good think.
And Martinelli, who's sped away to score, finds that it's not in the record books. Strangely enough, it's one of the really stats as we look again at this. It would have been, Gary, the 10th goal in a row that Arsenal Johnson would have scored left-footed.
Yeah, that angle there doesn't look like a free kick. It's the other one that Paul Tierney was drawn towards. And there is contact, but it is soft. There's no doubt about that.
Well, I can imagine for anti-media organisations totting up the VAR calls over yesterday and today.
Well, it's already been getting battered. We're getting even further so after that, I'm sure, particularly by Arsenal fans.
And by Saliba. Congo has done a good job filling in the middle of midfield. So first of all, Mohamed Elneny has been out for a long time, we believe. He was in for half an hour. He could be back next weekend from the start of the hotel. Alassi, nil-nil still. I mean, you've got someone who's structuring like that. They've got off the field, he's got a free kick, all from the goalkeeper.
Oh, that's brilliant from Jesus, the way in which he backs it to Moran, then pulls it down. Look at this. Like a target, man.
Gabriel.
He started the game well, Jesus.
As he did for Manchester City, going into more midfield area when there's the opportunity. Got cover from Rene Jacobi, behind Jacka now. Gabriel. There's Martinelli, across comes Moran, who shins it away. Did the job.
And even though that goal hasn't stood, it's definitely just changed Arsenal's momentum in the game. Started to play a little bit.
I wonder, it's hard for those officiating. But on replays, we don't expect mistakes. The naked eye has always been there. A lot of sympathy for those who take charge of matches at all levels of football. Here's Dallo. Williams Saliba, a teenager running from French football into being one of the younger, one of the better Premier League centre backs that he is now. Here's Bukayo Saka, he'll be 21 tomorrow, and he's making a great run here, snapped away by Moran. Wants to get it back.
My goodness.
As I mentioned them before the game, they've been absolutely critical.
What's got me from my own all the
Saka against Galicia.
Did you see that pass there?
Goes round him, through him.
You see pass that all
as well, just to intercept that pass into Odegaard.
First corner of the game. Jesus pulling away at the back pass.
Yeah, just isolating Eriksen from those corners.
Both clubs are in the Europa League this season. Arsenal go to Zurich on Thursday. United entertain Real Sociedad here. Hectic schedule of Sunday, Thursday matches come for both.
Well,
rush of over Rashford and over Real as well.
It's because the door's open. So it's a bit wonky. Right, I think I'm going to take this off and charge it this time. Should be alright now. 20 minutes for this game.
Putting himself about. Martinez. Yeah. By Zinchenko.
Yeah, the United centre backs know they're in for a game. 20 minutes in.
It's safe.
Hey!
You talked about Riyad Mahrez, sort of role model.
Yeah, you see quite a few of his goals that he scored. It's when he does this, uses the overlapping fullback as a decoy and cuts in on that left foot.
United did win this fixture last season, 3-2. Their only win in the last 8 Premier League meetings. They lost at the Emirates after that in April. There we are. It was Martinelli. Fair enough. Too much for Frank Saka and Gabriel Jesus. And 3-1 in April for Arsenal against United Emirates. Frank Saka scored a penalty, hasn't scored for Arsenal since then. That's it. That's a little time for him. Eriksen. Over the top, Ramsdale's ready for it.
Well, you see Arsenal have come into the game quite a bit since they scored that goal that was disallowed. Passing it a lot better.
It's a real compliment to Zinchenko that he's been preferred to Tierney, who is a very highly rated Arsenal player. Zinchenko has a little bit more variety to his play, possibly a little bit more composed on the ball. It's often at their best when Tierney is making those buccaneering runs down the left hand side. From the bench, Odegaard. Yeah, Saka inside. Lazio's float on it. And Saka goes again. Paul Tierney had a good look at it. I know when. After a lot of action.
Well, Arsenal getting the better of this game now.
Yellow card for Saliba.
I think he just pulled out Martinez on it when he went for the penalty. This is the break. Saliba just comes right across. This is the one here. He gets caught, Malicia, off Saka, and then you think he's just going to go through the back. He just stops short, Martinez. He thinks about going the whole way for the ball, but he's quite clever in the end. The United centre back just pulls his leg back.
from the counter-attack that came from the referee not stopping the play. Saliba was caught, having to make a tactical foul, and he booked for it.
Oh, Shaq is asking for the penalty. As is Gabriel Jesus. It wasn't.
It might be, it's gone. Manchester United starting very brightly. So picked up the pace of Sunderland to show why they are top of the Premier League. And that kind of control from Gabriel Jesus, that's brilliant under pressure.
Oh, fantastic. He's been really, really good from the first minute.
Anthony not quite on the same wavelength as McTominay. Top by Dallo.
Get out! He's faking. He's faking. Don't kick it out.
Gabriel Jesus nearly got away there.
He's getting
out. Right now.
Who is it? It's down.
Fernandez. Who?
It is. Colleague.
He wasn't happy, Fernandez. Oh, I don't think it's a good one. No, he just scrapes down his calf. He's looking.
What's that?
The referee's not seen it. They can be leg breakers, those ones. He's got a good view, the referee. It's not clever.
I was reading a newspaper article from none less than Wayne Rooney this morning, which said that the Manchester United right back of the day rattled into Jose Antonio Reyes with aplomb time and time again. Right back who's sitting alongside me now. Is it a that kind of challenge?
No, not really. I do remember one in the game, in that game, by Ruben Nistelrooy and Ashley Cole. But no, my word didn't tend to be scrapes down the shin or calf.
What's he going on about? Oh.
Use the desperation of getting back and being beaten.
We shouldn't forget what these fixtures used to be like when they were almost silverware decider in terms of not just the Premier League, but the FA Cups as well. And on occasion in the Champions League too.
Yeah, this has been a really good first half an hour. United, I think, were better in the first 10 minutes, 15 minutes, but Arsenal really responded well.
What are you drunk?
You had two nights of dinners at Dad's, didn't you?
What did you do? I've been
crying.
Just about
recovered. And Zinchenko has McTominay search for supremacy on the scoreline here. That's been ruled out. Half hour mark. Not funkiest, Manchester, but it is very warm, and when you're watching from home, you should maybe take that into account. Tells me the tempo is dropping a little bit. It's a pass, not just a boot upfield.
Oh, it's really good from Ramsdale and White.
And from Odegaard. There is Ben White. And for Zinchenko, athletic run to Martinelli. Wants to put plenty in the box.
Yeah. Nice first touch. Let him down a little bit, but then he just squeezed one across. Dallow's deflection nearly does for De Gea at the near post.
Ooh!
This has been very imaginative from their set pieces this season. That was Saka. Quite correct as he might have done. Saka puts it back in. Xhaka's in there again. It's another Arsenal corner. Good start for the Gunners.
To get in there. I mean, that's had the ball in the net. Sorry.
We've got three around with De Gea. Martinelli sits across to Romero. It's controlled well by Gabriel. Lokonga. Gabriel, that's across to the right hand side. And right, likewise. Likewise, and he's scraped away his palm. Xhaka and
Odegaard. Sorry.
That's this
score. Come on!
Eriksen defends.
I should hit it, Saka. He had lots of space in front of it.
Here come Arsenal again. Odegaard. Gabriel Jesus changes direction, loses McTominay. Great play from the Brazilian. Saka, Odegaard, around the back is Martinelli, and the pace of play nearly came off with an excellent move. Arsenal working their way finally into a position to attack De Gea's goal.
Yeah, we're seeing real high quality football from Arsenal. That attack in particular was brilliant. Going for goal. And here Paris back into a dangerous area, and that's where United get the foul. Jesus goes for an overhead kick and just whacks Varane.
It's great movement by Martinelli because he had to stay onside and still get round unattended as he did.
Yeah, him and Jesus have been absolutely brilliant. Jesus in particular has been the outstanding player on the pitch. Absolutely brilliant he has been in this first half an hour.
We have to make sure they cannot play, and at the moment they are playing Arsenal Football Club. Let's go back to White again. He approves with the news from Brighton earlier, and White. Xhaka. Excellent football from Arsenal again.
Anything you fancy in particular, sir?
I don't know.
Let the ball do the work. Eriksen likewise. Sancho. He's got on the outside of it. McTominay. Comes to the back in shape defensively. Against one here, Anthony against Zinchenko. Anthony trying to give him a bit of help, but Anthony is delayed.
That won't help, unfortunately.
Varane. Martinez to go all the way back to De Gea. Eric. A lovely ball.
Don't forget, Arsenal already scored a goal.
Universal acclaim.
And that wasn't the
Manchester United squad and of course from the supporters. Ericsson fed it into Fernandez. It all came from there.
Oh, Sadi Ato, a good start. And just has. Arsenal have been the better team in this last 15, 20 minutes, but this pass from Christian Eriksen is brilliant. And it opens up the whole game. Well done to Paul Tierney. He plays the advantage. And Rashford, well, he knows Anthony is there. And it's on a plate. He goes down early, Ramsdale. I mentioned before that left foot to cutting it up at right hand side. This is a dream position for the Brazilian.
Sent a message.
Straight away.
She said, tell Stephen, well done. Good for doing the 8 yards. And she said that, tell Stephen, I hope Arsenal win.
And Xhaka is having a row with the referee and Anthony. Not sure what it's over.
Celebration, maybe.
Oh, so we lost the flag so far at Derry.
It's been a really, really good game. We thought we'd get a good game. Both teams contributing.
To another Anthony Martial, of course, opened up on his debut.
Well, he'd been quiet for that last 15, 20 minutes. It's mostly the United team have been there.
Oh, there he is.
Yeah.
Injured. Still here. Let's credit Paul Tierney because referees had a bit of a pasting this weekend. Those on in the middle, and more those on VAR. Paul Tierney was right on the spot. Gabriel could easily have been penalised and probably even would have been booked, but by being so close, Tierney was able to assess the situation.
And a pretty good advantage in the fight between Jesus and Varane. Martinez continues, but it's the Arsenal centre forward who's winning that battle.
Not many fighting boys.
It's giving them a real tough time. Just keeps packing into them, out muscling them.
Arsenal have a free kick. I don't think Odegaard is over it. I think Martinelli is just holding his position. He doesn't want to clip it into the middle of the Arsenal skipper. It goes short, it's clever. The Saka is deflected a couple of times and it rolls comfortably for Danny De Gea in the end. Another warning to Manchester United.
Yeah, plenty of innovation from Arsenal on these set pieces. Really clever. Saka stands in the offside position, then comes short to receive it to Pete.
Longest header. This is a Rashford. Right. He's so good. Zinchenko trying to exert the right of reply from the North London club, Martinelli. Quite coordinated, nearly. Anthony. Quality on show here, as you would expect from two in-form teams.
Yeah, we looked at those front threes, didn't we, before the game. Sancho, Rashford, Anthony, Saka, Jesus and Martinelli. And they're showing up.
Bit of a wild swipe by Anthony. When you were doing your homework on him, you did find that he had a couple of red cards.
A little bit of petulance.
Oh, Inchenko. Gabriel Jesus again, leaving Manchester United in his wake. And Kieran's got back. There we go. Saka.
Come on! For God's sake.
White tries to cross. Granit Xhaka puts it back into the middle of where Eriksen knew he had time for a touch. Before the clearance. Dallow. Coutinho thought he played Manchester United advantage here, but Rashford has stayed down. And now the referee really has got to play on. It's up to the players to put it out. Rashford's getting to his feet. Martinelli's on the ball. Rising in time is Marcus Rashford. Bruno Fernandes. It's intense. At times inspired.
Yeah, it's a proper game.
It is a throwback game.
It is. Speed of the game. Rashford doing what Jesus can do at the other end, just backing in and holding off Gabriel.
Just put the car down up the road. Just look, is it getting dark now?
So many of you are now tracked in the Super League and full Sky Sports, starting next Saturday. Spurs against Manchester United at 11:30 and Manchester City against the Arsenal women's team next Sunday. The overall management, the Arsenal ladies team of a good friend of ours, Gary Lewin, former England physio. This time, high octane first half. And two teams on winning streaks. And the final routine, and you put Martinelli. Reacted to the throw initially. Arsenal a man light. McConnell, Martinelli's on his feet.
Don't really have time. Yeah. Just try and get level before half time, it'll be on.
I'll tell you what, I'll put in a couple of tricking jam sticks for you.
Yeah. I don't want the other one.
The awareness.
We'll get one and
take
can
a touch.
Have
Yeah, he was never set, was he? To get the ball out of his feet properly, it wasn't there for him.
Every time Arteta's team has conceded, only four times this season, they've hit back within 8 minutes. Well, it's beyond 8 minutes now. And they've still got 4 minutes in this first half, and then there are 45.
I hate the scoreline, but teams before, but particularly after that first 10 minutes, they've been pretty good.
Tommy, not lucky.
appreciated the chance. Stretch his legs again.
Really good. United just started better than Arsenal from that moment where that goal was disallowed. They really dominated the next 20 minutes. And actually, United scored at a point whereby they looked like they're really struggling in the game.
United scored it, and they said looking for something that would cement his place in United's history before the first half of his debut had finished.
I think if you're a fan of both teams, you'll have enjoyed the way your team played in this first half. That's a little bit disappointing that this allowed goal.
And if you love football, you'll be enjoying the whole spectacle. Getting a bit over ambitious. He's obliged the manager that he's played under before by slotting in the opening goal. Paul Tierney played a very good advantage for that, but Arsenal fans will think, why did he disallow Martinelli's goal at 0-0? The foul against Ødegaard, who's still protesting, contributing to the first half. Gabriel Jesus has been sensational for Mikel Arteta. At the moment, they're on the losing end thanks to Anthony's debut goal at Old Trafford. United 1, Arsenal 0 at the break.
Don't copyright.
chicken.
Hi everyone, I'm back. I hate this referee. Nubby bent prick. Oh, he can get in the bin.
Is the sunlight, mine is the moon, yeah. All of the ones living so free.
Let's do the break. I can't go cover it because no one met on my video. Well. The Sheffield United team see if they can compete for top four. Get another drink.
Never stop
from Matt, this is lovely. Sets him up for one touch finish, coming in on his left hand side.
It's a dream moment for him.
What a dream chance
as well.
Brilliant. Such a good chance from him again. One touch finish. The keeper needs a big gap on that side. Brilliant start to his Man United career.
He enjoyed it, didn't he? And so did everyone here. Apart from the Arsenal contingent who thought they should have been ahead already. Do they have a point, Paul?
Yeah, they do. They do. I mean, Eriksen's gone down very weakly. I mean, you know, you can't say it was a push in the back, and but he has gone down, and as Roy said during the game, you might as well just go down and fall over, because they're going to go back. It was a great finish, great weight of pass, great finish, and I think when that happened, Man United were on top, and it was like a boxer getting hit, and then the boxer going, cool, he can punch hard, and I think Man United were petrified after that for a while, and I think they're very fortunate to be in.
Do you think that's a foul, Jimmy?
I think it's ridiculous that they go back to that. I don't think that it is a foul. They have changed. They're saying we're going to be more lenient. Yes, there is contact. Eriksen is just weak there, weaker than the other player. Yeah, and it's just a turnover of play and a transition.
He makes no contact with the ball. That's still.
He doesn't make contact with the ball, but you're allowed to have contact with players, and he is just being weak. He falls on the floor, and he's being weak. It's not a, for me. It's not a foul.
Do you think it's soft?
Yeah, it's soft, yeah, of course. But I think what helps United there is that Odegaard, he doesn't actually get touch on the ball. And again, obviously we played in a different era. Not a foul in our day, but today, the way the game is going, you get touched. But they're all doing it. It's been going on a few times the first half. A number of players are doing it. They're staying down with their touch. They don't like to see it. So the way the game is going, I suppose it is a foul.
But you don't have to touch the ball. He's not kicking the player. He's just coming in contact with
engaging.
You know? And that's allowed. That's what they want. They want it to be more flowing. Why is that a free kick?
It was a big warning, though, wasn't it, for Manchester United? It came as a bit of a shock to them, but they managed to ride their way through it, got that bit of fortune, and this is how they responded. Anthony gets his first goal in a Manchester United shirt, and United fans are going wild for their new man.
Have you seen one of these, Dad?
One of those.
From long-range electric driving to boundless connections, let Hyundai power your ride. At LV, we've always believed our car insurance should look after your wallet just as well as it looks after your car. So you can get great value cover from just £219. And we pay out on 99% of claims. So that's one less thing to worry about. It could be why our customers rate us as excellent on Trustpilot. To get a quote, rent to lv.com.
Internet's panic again. What a nightmare.
Dad? Stop spinning.
It's been loading forever.
Save yourself from broadband nightmares. Together, BT and EE bring you unbreakable Wi-Fi. Only BT's hybrid broadband is backed up by EE, the UK's best network.
With Auto Switch Up, you're free to swap to a new phone anytime you like. Any reason? As often as you like. With no need to pay off your contract. For an extra £3.99 a month, bolt on or included on selected plans. Switch up to new when it suits you.
Smash Life with Set for Life from the National Lottery. Win £10,000 every month for 30 years. Set for Life from the National Lottery. Enjoy a freshly prepared 99p mayo chicken, part of the McDonald's Saver menu.
Oh, it's going dark now.
Getting into your flow. It's all about how you start.
Chicken, mum, drumsticks, and
exfoliating bath. Clears a path on your skin before the blades for effortless shaving and exfoliation in one stroke. Because when you start to flow.
Yeah, I'll take the drawing this with me. Let's hope. We've got performance to set my off.
With the Gillette Labs range. Gillette, the best a man can get.
You've been working from home, but your flatmate just took up the drums as a hobby.
I need Indeed. Indeed you do.
Indeed I do.
Indeed CV helps you personalise your job search. And even helps the right job find you.
I see you're willing to. I see trees are green, the grass is tall. No, not rabbit. No, cook carrots, please. Are you going to cook carrots?
Loot your way into stock trading. Download Revolut now.
I am what I am. I don't want praise. I don't want pity. And so, if I love this bottle, let me back off. Why
just need to see her. So I can talk to her properly.
Oh.
Hey!
He's fucking
dead.
He's run off!
McCann's out of the picture. My fight's one that can join forces and prosper. Meaning? The towel's off.
We're professional thieves, aren't we? No.
You never want to see a legend retiring. Reminds me of when I retired.
Legend.
But now it's time to move on.
Get the right result. Sky Sports coverage of the Premier League, sponsored by We Buy Any Car.
Some great live sport coming your way this week on Sky Sports. On Thursday, we've got LPGA Tour Golf for you. First day of the Proven Queen City Championship. There's the return of the Women's Super League on Saturday. England take on Indian swimming in the first T20 on Saturday night, and an all-female fight night on Saturday, headlined by Clarissa Shields and Savannah Marshall. All to come this coming weekend. And here at Old Trafford on Super Sunday, United's new big money signing has the home support on the edge of their seats in the first half. We've seen all the tricks and the flicks. Well, that for a dance move. And substance too. He's got the only goal so far.
Just leave it. No, don't come. Excuse me. Have we been overcharged? £20 for a pint of lager.
Ah, yes, sir. Don't forget about the charge for the glass.
And £30 for laying the table.
Standard fee, sir.
What's a consultation fee?
You did ask a question about the wine.
With TalkTalk Full Fibre, the things that should come as standard do come as standard. It just makes sense. TalkTalk.
Manchester United in front, thanks to Anthony. Do you see a way back for Arsenal given that first half performance, Paul?
I think, yeah, if they play like they did the first half, I think it's dangerous now. They may, and I can sit back and they can counter-attack. So for me, first 15 minutes, so important.
Let's see. Gary Neville and Martin Tyler.
Golly! Oh, you know what? I just had the Everts on during
that. 1-0 down. Their last six league wins in this round have all been by 1-0. That's how it happened today. Last time they won by scoring two was 1979, two from Alan Sunderland. Sancho. We've seen in the race scored his two goals recently. It's not one to panic in possession.
No, there was a time where you get it in the corner and it would be just put your foot through it, get rid of it, but not now. These lads like to dribble out in those types of positions.
No changes at half time. Touch by Lokonga. Okay, loose. Chance this down as well.
God! We just needed someone there, didn't we?
Mm.
Carry on where they left off at the end of the first half.
Oh. He played that ball a few times under pressure, Ramsdale, in the first half to Ben White.
Doris and they, again, still in the way by Gabriel in possession, played from the back. for being a sinner in that instead of being to score the winner. The Emirates. Zinchenko, and now Martinelli, Saka getting into the penalty area, because there as well. Force a way through, and Zinchenko wins it back. Slightly wrong foot to Martinelli, and promising position.
Steve, you know that Arsenal are more important.
He's empty again.
Of winning this game, don't you? Of course they are. Of going out there again, aren't you?
He takes it back in towards the bodies.
Little mini roasters, is that right?
Maybe better have gone further inside at that time.
So, 3 goals and 3 assists already. Saliba.
Well, it's interesting how Arsenal are doing it. Jesus is dropping right in. Odegaard's coming over there to this side. They've got the play and the system working well. Saka.
Mm. Right, goes on the outside.
Oh! There's a reason why they're top of the table.
Sancho. So close to the line. Always the one. Urging his team to press in numbers and they did successfully.
Oh, come on!
This isn't a bloody FIFA street.
Oh, I didn't say it was.
Jackson. White press, so they can pick across. The way by Varek, the way Lokonga. And Gabriel. Manchester United sitting in. Partly by choice, also because Arsenal started with a good share of possession.
It's just I think it's quite dangerous for Arsenal as well because Rashford and Anthony ready to counter attack.
Even be encouraging them to do that.
Yeah, I think the more that Arsenal get drawn forward, not playing well Arsenal, but could they get done on the counter attack? That's what he'll be hoping. So early and so deep because he was thinking about suit United. But where he was best in that first half, playing right up against Ferran and Martinez.
Come on, Gabby.
Martinelli. Since we've got to the board, it's 3-2. Hello. That's stumbled out, but I'm sure in the end, he actually did keep the ball. There he is again. Saliba.
Was with his left foot.
Martinelli. Saka. That's the use of the hand, but Saka. That's the way it's been going for him in front of goal.
They want a penalty. They want a penalty. Paul Chin is not giving it to them. tries to read it, Valencia, and he ends up in a really bad position. Saka just pulls it across goal, whereas Anthony in that first half had his left foot to set it out into that corner.
Second's been completed.
It was good play again. Initially, it's Jesus who just rolls Martinez. When he's played up against either centre-back, they just can't handle him. And Ødegaard misses that first chance. Could he have taken a touch? I think he had enough time. And this touch is brilliant, and Melissa thinks he's going to knock it back towards Ben White. He doesn't.
Well, the appeal first and foremost were for corner.
Corner, yeah. And then they realise that there's been a follow-through with motion.
Saka responded to treatment. Got an injury added to the insult of not getting either a corner or a penalty. Chiefs, but 1-0 is enough. Both Southampton and Leicester. Ramsdale. White. Big, did score here last season. It's in a 3-2 defeat. Should have scored here today.
Should be things
in. Nice mask on yet again. Worthy of league leaders. Goes round the back, Ben White coming in, strikes the top of the crossbar. Gabriel Jesus was in front of White.
Brilliant football, full length of the pitch. Ramsdale plays it out to Ben White, into Ødegaard, and then Arsenal just off. Most of the team involved, it felt like he's in there, flying into the back post, but just wants to eclipse the bar. Arsenal by far the better team in the first 10 minutes of this second half. He's happy. He knows they're playing well.
They're all playing well.
They're providing a test for the rejuvenated Manchester United. Watching the Arsenal players. With my wife, but Jesus is a little bit back on his heels. The first time I even think of that. His performance in 55 minutes. United have the goal. I thought they should have had one.
We mentioned some of those games from all those years ago, Martin. This is not too dissimilar in Patton, where Arsenal play lots of football.
In a place like that.
They have to sit in and defend and then try and get on the counter-attack against them. A brilliant football team back then, and this Arsenal team are playing some great football today.
Rashford drawing in. Ramsdale. Knew he had to get his skip away quickly.
Fucking hell, man. Let's remove this one, the Potter on the back. Going out, right? Oh, well.
Yeah, Martinelli. He offers width, but also offers a threat when he comes in from that wide position when the ball is delivered from the other flank. Saka.
That's
it.
It's come right again, Saka. Just grab his shirt grabbed.
It's Ronaldo coming on. Oh no, we can't be.
Left. An endearing impression to the Manchester United supporters for this.
Oh, yes.
They need a bit more. The other side of the game now. Cristiano Ronaldo, will he supply it?
He's had an hour. Scored a goal. Cristiano Ronaldo. Sure will go up top. Rashford will go wide.
They scored home and away against Arsenal last season. Martin Odegaard with the signal. United trying to hold high-ish line. I took something they're very useful in defending set pieces. Zinchenko, Xhaka. Saliba. Give an impersonation of Martinelli out there.
Ooh. Awesome, you passed on your first try. Well done.
Odegaard. Ryan Martinez. On the overlap outside, after an end came inside, it was an overlap, underlap in the end. And what can Ronaldo bring here? I think Arteta will fear his goal scoring capabilities, but his team will get the shots on target, just the one, but it doesn't include a disallowed goal.
Come on, Tucker! Yes! No, of course not. Hope not.
How many goals these days have just scored off?
Where's his first goal? I don't know if he's got an assist, but that's his first goal for Arsenal this season. He's not been that. He's not had a good start to the season, but I'll take it.
Just one away win in 15 Premier League visits, the last 15 for the side of level here, and Gary Neville, you can't really dispute the value of it.
Boys, they've been brilliant in the first 15 minutes this second half.
Come on. I think United will probably start playing again now, because they're just trying to...
Well, I better watch it, Arsenal, because they just beat that other goal in the first half, didn't they?
But it has been deserved. It's been coming. They've been on the ropes, Manchester United.
Fell for him. Great, and he took
he
the
just
shot.
Squeezed it through his legs. I think it's Martinez who throws himself to the ground in the end. But we've got a game on now in this last half an hour of Mikel Arteta. Well, he was happy with his team 2 minutes ago. He'll be even happier now.
Well, forgive me, a footnote. It's another left-footed goal for Arsenal. 10 in a row in the Premier
left-footed
League.
Left-footed goals? Is that something then?
That's his first in that sequence.
I'll score your left foot and then lift your left-footed player.
Saka. Nkonga. Chased down by Bruno Fernandes. Arsenal got the bit between their teeth. And they've got an equalising goal. Saka holds off Martinez. Xhaka then holds him off just about. No complaints from the experienced Switzerland international.
That's miles off.
And he's run up against Jadon Sancho. Trying to get place in the history books. That record actually goes back to 1984, the last time Manchester United were winning at a half time in a league game and lost.
Still half hour, just.
But not the Ipswich game.
Come on.
Odegaard.
No, it wasn't a foul.
He shouldn't have been offside, Rashford. He was looking right across the line.
Still fouled.
Back. Let's see, with a really good challenge. And Eriksen just needs that time to play his pass. He can see the back of Gabriel. He goes early.
Come on!
Yeah, Xhaka just splitting into that left channel, Ødegaard into this right channel, causing United's fullbacks real problems, and Jesus. Absolutely sensational, just everything going through him. When he's involved, Arsenal a massive threat.
Corner. Back to Zinchenko. Back to Martinelli, who whips it in.
Oh, be careful! Bloody hell! Close one, my dear. You've got a timer on for that.
In charge of the situation. There's Bruno Fernandes. Makeshift right back. Out of the danger. Crowd pressure on the far side.
Yeah, I think the throw. He tried to just let it roll out, but I think it did just look like it came off his stomach. We'll see. Did he just touch it? I thought he did. Maybe.
Whether it was over the line or not, I guess. Hey, Fred.
Oh, this is a tricky one.
Of course, wins there, the midfield for two previous managers.
Eric Ten Hag having to go back, to go forward. He's got to get a grip of this game because Arsenal dominated the ball, particularly through midfield and through Xhaka in that left side of that midfield for Arsenal.
So we at least deserve something out of this, don't you?
Yeah.
Look on me.
Just getting outnumbered, it's that Zinchenko coming into that central midfield position as well.
Eriksen. Fernandes for Rashford.
Come on.
Middle of Arsenal, go Manchester United. And
Rashford has scored the lead. Oh, for fuck's sake. What is going on?
Eriksen, Fernandes, Rashford. Two up.
I'm talking of playing, dude.
I was just talking about Arsenal's midfield. But they get counter-punched here. They give the ball away in a poor area. It's that combination, Eriksen into Fernandes, as you said.
It's not for Rashford to leave,
but this isn't true. Because it saw his feet up, picking up.
There's three of them, and one of
them. Marcus Rashford got it stuck under his feet. He's through. But his first touch isn't brilliant. And it's just that little deflection that might help him in the end. He takes it over Ramsdale. And Manchester United, it's been such a poor 20 minutes, a difficult 20 minutes. A back in front.
Well, Marcus Rashford scored two on his Premier League debut against Arsenal in 2016. He's played 13 times since then before today and not scored against them. And now he's come up for the very precious moment for his side.
It's a really good run for Marcus Rashford. Out to win, Sancho off still, no change in the substitution.
Well, Fred comes on now with a lead to help defend rather than a period of possession.
It's the deal with
United needed to stop.
Yeah, it's the deal with Ødegaard on this side. Him and Xhaka are having a real presence on the game.
Eriksen again for Ronaldo to Rashford. And it's, from every football fan's point of view, even Arsenal fans, it's such an uplifting story, Christian Eriksen.
to see him stroking passes around. When you give him time to do that, and also done it a couple of times to their cost. Assist on either goal.
I'm sorry, Tia, it'll probably take a fraction longer than I thought it might.
Forward here.
How long is that timer on for?
It's on for 20 minutes. I've got to go and check the potato. The roasties and turn them over.
It has happened once before. In 2005, Cristiano
Ronaldo came on
as a substitute.
It's fresh chicken.
You think back at what he developed as a player, but he was going through a phase then where he was still trying to please not only Alec Ferguson, but also his teammates, Gary, as well.
Yeah, that was his early days at Manchester United where he wasn't consistent.
I'll be bringing in your celebratory.
That inconsistency probably went through to about 2006 when he became absolutely unbelievable.
Make a picture on here. Alston's very close to being in further trouble.
You sound like all the weaknesses.
Ronaldo, McTominay! A desperate, really unsuccessful challenge from Gabriel.
Ramsdale corrects his own mistake. He plays a pass into Zinchenko that gives Zinchenko no chance. Fair play to him. His reaction after that is quick. He's out to Fernandes.
Arsenal conceded direct from a corner on Wednesday. This is an outswinger from Eriksen. Ronaldo up for it. Still a real danger aerially.
Well, this sprint is unbelievable.
And that's it. Defended by Zinchenko. Zinchenko had a very good picture of what was around him to do a header like that. This header, as though it might widen the gap. Brought on to do.
Exactly. Get closer to Odegaard.
Rashford. Coming out.
Fuck off! You fucking cunt! Miles is going, yeah, fuck you!
Okay, James, we're going to cost you a yellow card.
He's a brilliant defender, Jesus. The way in which he gets back in and back tackles as well has contributed in the attacking sense. Brilliant to watch. The game's brilliant to watch.
Deserve to be where they are in the table. They're not finished yet, but Gabriel Jesus.
There's loads of time left in this game. This man's still huge threat.
One of those 11 match to derby played in for City, in which he didn't score, but he won four times, all of them here. The regular support striker. Smith Rowe and see the new Vieira.
That's
a bit of a goal, isn't it? I mean, end to end.
Time to look up and supply the cross. Just pushed behind. Movement was very good. Cross not so good.
Yeah, it was. Just held his run on this side. Just there. There's Gabriel in the middle, I think, playing him on.
Well, messages in midfield. Fully understood what he wants from them with the ball and what he wants from them off the ball. Odegaard, who was a bit of a doubt for this game, damaged ankle against Aston Villa. This way to Emil Smith Rowe, who, like Odegaard, scored in this fixture here last season. The chance for Ross 3-2.
Arsenal Ross 3-2.
Yeah.
Good day. It's interesting, isn't it?
Hunger. That's right.
I'm going to check on it, alright?
And it's the first sight because he had an injury pre-season for Arsenal fans. The new Vieira.
I'm trying to work out who's going to play left back for us. It looks like Martinelli.
Fabio Vieira came from Porto, £30 million. He's been likened in the style of play where he plays to Bruno Fernandes.
He's throwing the kitchen sink at this. The amount of attacking players and options he has on the pitch. Incredible.
More than 15 minutes to go. Leveled through Saka. And then went behind to a razor sharp red break. And it off by Rashford. Martinelli. United throw. I'm not talking about that one. Right at the start, maybe after the Manchester City failure to win at Aston Villa, a little bit more of a freedom about Arsenal in this game. More freedom here belongs to Christian Eriksen. Rashford's up with him. Eriksen looks for Rashford.
What's up? It's not!
Eriksen this time does get the assist.
I have to say, when Mikel Arteta made those substitutes, I thought it was either going to be a 5-1 or a 3-2 the other way because it just looks so bold. But the space that Christian Eriksen has is absolutely incredible. Arsenal, well, did they need to go so desperate so early? It's onside. Eriksen's onside.
Fuck.
Rashford's onside.
Manchester United are on top.
Yeah, absolutely. That's bold. But I have to say, I was thinking this could be 4 or 5-1, or it could just be a mess for Manchester United. The other way, and Arsenal could go and score 2 or 3. It looks like it's going to be the former.
Well, it's a throwback to Marcus Rashford for his Premier League debut over 6 years ago. He came at that European game just before that, in which he scored in his official United debut twice as well. And for all the efforts of Gabriel Jesus and his teammates, it's Manchester United 3, Arsenal 1.
Well, that thing is, it could still be 3-3, but the way Arsenal are approaching this game, as I say, it could be 5-1.
Protests. I think Gabriel Jesus was in the thick of it. Rashford is on and Patrick. And now the question is, with the multi-ball, which ball do you get? But he hasn't got it yet. Arsenal. Now, let's see. Triple change coming out. Samira, substitute number two, away wins about to make his Old Trafford foul. Another very highly priced arrival around the £70 million mark.
Yeah, he looks like Eric Ten Hag. He made that press substitution. even though the second goal went in, it looks like he's going to make two more defensive substitutions just to deal with the amount of attacking players that have come on the pitch.
It was on side.
So they've checked it, obviously. Swipe them up, haven't they? A bit.
Facing the league leaders, just like facing Liverpool, bringing the best out of Manchester United. This Manchester United.
One thing you can do, stick your fingers up at everyone, Steve. Because you still be at the top of the.
Gabriel
Jesus. Oh, yeah. Well, they could have done with the draw.
No, it's twice I've watched him here, and twice I've seen him get cramped.
Rashford's got a problem as well.
Yeah, well, he's either got cramp or a hamstring. He's got a groin, it looks like. I'm not surprised the way in which he cleared that.
Harry Maguire. Always get the chance to play in the Premier League again. There's some extraordinary comments about him in England. And even if he has to fight hard to get his Premier League, but there are going to be injuries. It's going to be Europa League. He's going to get football.
Yeah.
Not going to sit on the bench until November or whenever Gareth Southgate.
No, this is football. Other than that, particularly blessed with loads of centre halves anyway. He's on. Casemiro as well. United got three holding midfield players on. Fred, McTominay and Casemiro. With Ericsson and Fernandes as well, and Cristiano Ronaldo remains as a forward on the pitch for Manchester United. He's up top.
And the change for Arsenal, Ben White. The hero of Sonny Ashes, a more attacking, natural right back. They made that change against Aston Villa. Look here by McTominay. Here's Smith Rowe.
United just showing them a little bit off the pace, which is understandable. Casemiro initially, and Harry Maguire in the unenviable position of being one on one against Gabriel Jesus.
Taking one for the team that he hasn't been part of for a week or so. Score a goal. The left footer seems to be what's required these days. Leo Vieira, who is also left footed, has walked away from it. Engaged with Bruno Fernandes. He knows that there's problems there. Fred, a different kind of draft excluded position. Jacket Arthur really need this to go in. Looks like the last 10 minutes.
Not hopeful.
Added time. Jacket takes, comes off the wall. Ranger not cleared yet for Manchester United.
What are you drinking?
I think he still would have got there had it been a better pass. But Arsenal have just lost all the shape since these substitutions. They were dominating the game, they had the ball. Now they're in disarray at the back. He nearly gets a fourth.
Cristiano Ronaldo played in the game, the 49 people run ended by Manchester United. And also played in the game seen before when Manchester United had a penalty, there would have been no Invincibles if Van Nistelrooy scored that late penalty. It was early in the 03-04 season. It's extraordinary that he's still out on a football pitch, playing at this level, at this age. Yeah, there's a tantrum or two, but there is talent beyond belief.
Arsenal have just let that second Manchester United goal disrupt them too much. They were the better team, they were dominating every facet of the game. That second goal really has just thrown them.
They're not trying to pick up the tempo with a much changed side with the substitutions.
Problem is they've lost the shape on the ball now, it's a little bit all over the place.
Smith Rowe. Gabriel Jesus, 3-2, last season, and Nketiah! Maguire crossed the run without making a foul.
The control of this gate, Nketiah.
Material, are we? Going down the years, in the present, when the league was formed. Wonderful games between Ferguson's United and Wenger's Arsenal. Where at stake so often. This is right up there. Saka. Martinelli. Gabriel Jesus, and shot. First time in an indication what Fabio Vieira might bring. Not quite, of the ilk of Patrick Vieira, a few are. He doesn't come from Senegal, he comes from Portugal. I'm going to tell you about next weekend's Saturday Night Football. A good result for Manchester City if it stays this way. Two for Sunday, West Ham against Newcastle. And Crystal Palace against Manchester United, who are closing in. Successive Premier League win. There's a Monday night football as well. If you're of a certain age, Leeds against Nottingham Forest has a real resonance to it. Coming back to the Brian Clough days. Yeah. Jesus trying to steer it on, Saka can play it on. He stayed on side. Tomiyasu for Bukayo Saka, who's already scored once. That's a handball for the fans. And De Gea's goal. Saka. Try the difficult thing when you're attacking third and you're 3-1 down. Didn't come off for him. Fred, sack it. Yes. Followed through.
Yeah, just a little bit of frustration. Erik ten Hag's substitutions have just made it a lot more difficult for Arsenal now to poke it through midfield into those spaces they were getting before. Five very tight in midfield in front of that back four. And Saka, he sees Bolisia get up, just follows through on it.
It happens. Bukayo Saka's on the verge of agreeing a new long-term deal with the club that he's been so good for and has been so good to him. Using a diagram or two.
No, and those two are just playing tucked in now off the sides, making that midfield even more compact.
There is a place for those players in the pace and intensity.
Eriksen
in Premier League football.
I have to say that Eriksen's been very, very good for United.
Player of the match to award, and he must be close.
He is, I think he is. Yeah. Just, I mean, I would have said he's used up to an hour and 65 yeah. minutes yeah. all day long. But I think Eriksen's contribution leaves me making him man of the match.
In the football sense, he's Eric's son. Putting into practice what the new manager wants on the pitch.
And he's just managed his last 25 minutes better, Erik ten Hag, I feel.
Harry, we talked before we came on air about the way Arsenal lost their Champions League championship in the last 6 months. They were blown away, young team, by the atmosphere of Spurs and at Newcastle. Not been quite like that today.
Martin, they've been fantastic, I have to say, for 65, 70 minutes, but quite a bit of immaturity in this last 20 minutes. So I think the substitutions, the three substitutions at once was, I thought it was strange in the happening, because I thought it's a bit of a kitchen sink job whereby you could go and get done on the counter-attack, which they did. I don't think they needed to do that at that point in the game. There was still 20 minutes to go, they were playing really well, they were working chances. Manchester United's goal on the counter-attack was against the run of play. All of a sudden it became a game that became easier for Manchester United than it did for Arsenal with those subs.
Vieira. That needed to be played by McTominay. McTominay was coming in behind him.
Oh, he surpassed this.
On run through.
Yeah.
Run offside. Undisciplined from McTominay.
And Arsenal fans will be really disappointed, but so I think they played really well that first 60-70 minutes. Brilliant in the game.
Martinelli with the corner. They're on the break again. Eriksen's on the ball again, not quite this time. Here's Gabriel Jesus.
He's going to score here.
Manchester United will get a bit
closer to
Stuffle.
Martinella.
Let's
go back to
Gabriel,
who just spins it in. Consolation
prize.
Up a little bit,
dinner.
Funny.
Yeah. Oh,
it's
sounds
like a really strange thing to say, whether the 3-1 beating at the moment, but actually feel more confident in Arsenal's top four chances having watched them today than I do the previous four or five matches against the teams they've played against. They've been really good at times. Like I said, they'll get that last part of the games right more often than not if they carry on playing like this.
Ooh, yeah. Jesus, and the shot by Smith Rowe was an instant one. He couldn't quite control it to get it on target. He was in the right place, bursting onto the ball.
Yeah, it's Cristiano Ronaldo's pecs that caused him the problem. We've seen him with his top off, and when he played that ball back into the middle of United's defence, it caused United a little bit of a problem.
We had a look at that challenge by Maguire on the Diego Vieira.
Yeah. Look, now he's here, Cristiano Ronaldo, for the rest of the season. Erik ten Hag. He's kept neutral on him. They've both got to get on with it. He can be a big player for United. Maybe not always starting, which will be difficult for him.
coming in at the back post. Ronaldo wants to tap in. And, kicks the ball.
He was there, and I think he wants it a little bit quicker from Bruno Fernandes, but symptomatic of this last 20 minutes that the counter-attack's been on. It's just that obviously Manchester United's attacking players are off the pitch. They ended up with midfield players up there, but could he have played it a little bit quicker? I'll give credit to Gabriel.
Corner in the final minute of a fine game of football.